Hey, Ginger Boy, welcome to Super Mario Land 6 Golden Coins, Super Mario Land 2. I decided I really need to play a Side B project along with Super Mario Brothers X Koopa Islands thing. And the main reason is that game just gets me super frustrated sometimes. And I need to have something take my mind off of it. Anyway, there's this. Let me just, not input audio. Turn down the volume a little bit. It's super loud for me. Okay. Still really loud. Wow. Doing things on camera that I really should have done beforehand. Okay, there we go. Anyway, we have the little mushroom house here. Kind of the first level, I guess? These giant blocks and giant Goombas and me dying because I haven't played this game for years? Okay. Let's do this again better. So, it's kind of like any Mario game out there. I mean, I slightly remember playing this on a Game Boy Color, so it had color, I want to say? But, yeah, old black and white style, not too bad. Not too bad at all. Losing my power up. That's okay. Screen scroll. Can you call them screen scrolling pipes? Well, screen scrolling pipes. Nice little feature of the game. Then you have these turtles. Unlike in Super Mario Land 1, where the turtles would explode, these turtles don't explode. So, big difference there. So, little jumpy Goomba. The Goombas in this version jump really super high. Actually, isn't there a thing? Maybe not. I could have sworn there was a invisible block under there, but I guess not. Little piranha plant that come in or out of those pipes really quickly. Hearts are 1-ups. And yes, there are still stars, and they tell you how many enemies you've killed. After 5, you get a 1-up, and that bell was the midway point. So, yes, midway point. This is still really loud, so hold on just a second. Okay, that's better. If it's quiet, I'm sorry, I will fix that next time, I guess? The reason why I find it so loud is, I just find it really loud, and so I turn it down, and I kind of go by my recording software, and if it's saying that it's really loud or not. So here we have the end of the level. If you hit the top bell, you get a bonus game. If you go through the goal, you get just nothing. So this one, you kind of have to do it ahead of time. You can get 3 lives, a carrot, or a fire flower. And if you've never played the game before, the carrot is kind of like the feather of this game. Let's see. Let's go over to here first. No, this is the gambling machine. I forgot about that. Forgot that was the gambling machine. Oh yeah. Turtle, that eats you. There really is no World 1, World 2. There's just different zones. So, let's go to Toy Zone. I always like Toy Zone. Even though it says, like, Mario Zone. Hold on just a second. So many distractions. Okay. Anyway, I don't even remember what I was saying. This game, Toy Zone, one of my favorite zones. I know it's called Mario Zone, but it's really, like, a Toy Zone, a Clockwork Zone, whatever you want to call it. Because as you can see, there's these little gears and stuff. And some of them move, some of them don't. It's just a really nice area in general. I really like this area. those things are absolutely nothing. Oh yeah, they're saw blades. That's what they are. Oh, I got hit. Forgot about that. Then these are... I don't remember what those are. But these ones spin and drop you off of them. And I almost fell onto a spike, which I did that time. So these you kind of need to, like, jump across them really fast. And, yeah, it's kind of carrying of Super Mario Bros. 2. Oh yeah, those. You can jump up with them. I forgot. And saw blades. Oh, bad spinny gear. Okay. Oh boy. And going in a pipe and getting a carrot! So here is where I was saying that carrots are like your feathers. You get rabbit ears. And they're very mean about the midway point of that, but it's kind of to teach you that the ears let you float. It's kind of like the super cape, the original design for the cape. And yeah, I can jump on these. If you don't remember the original design for the cape, it was originally designed to allow Mario to float, but not fly. So you were going to be able to float long distances, but you were not going to be able to fly, though that was changed later on to allow flight. So the rabbit ears are kind of like that, you know, raccoon tail without the flight as well. So they just allow you, I believe, to jump higher and to float. But here we are. Took the second way, and can't remember if... No, you can't stand on those. And, of course, that's going to despawn because I fell all the way down here. Jeez. Mean. Mean game. Okay. Oh, no, it didn't despawn. I forgot. Do those... I mean, I don't... I haven't played this game for a long time, so it's one of those I don't fully remember everything about this game. And here is, like, another little obstacle course for you to, you know, get good with the wings. Mario Zone. Second. Here's a little bubble land. Oh, yeah, with the cannon pigs. Cannon pigs. They are made of pork and cannonballs. They're kind of like the Sniffits of this game. They're very interesting enemies. I always like them. Do-do-do-do, that bubble has spikes on it. And there's a lot of this, you jump to not right and you will fall down. Though, granted, you could do this whole thing on the bottom area, I believe. But that is another one up. They're very, very generous with the lives in this game, and I believe one of these pipes, yes, this one leads down, and you want to not jump here, or back there, because that would lead you back up that one, the first pipe, but you want to go down the second, or up the second one. Oh yeah, and then the bear. You kill the bear and you ride its ball. And Mario's feet are kind of acting funky with the ball. Never noticed that before. You always notice stuff on emulators you've never noticed in game just because you have a much larger screen. And I got hit again, Cannon Pig. That would be a very interesting enemy to add into Minecraft. A cannon pig. Granted, I'm horrible at making mods, because I don't really know JavaScript very well. Something I would like to learn in the future! Yes, you can jump on them. I could not remember if you could or not. Ooh, and there's this, where I don't remember. Okay, that's a mushroom, that's a Goomba. Oh, I wanted the carrots. I knew there was a carrot, but I couldn't remember which one it was in. There was a block. No. So, I believe if you had the carrot, you could get the secret exit. Or not. It's not a secret exit, it's the bell. Granted, some of these levels actually do have secret exits to them. So, that is something to keep in mind. A little bit of lag here. But, jump bell. And there we go. Oh, it's this one. Do that. Up, up, up. Okay, carrot. That is good with me. Do. Yeah, and what I didn't show is you can actually pick which plunger that you hit. Anyway, this has been Ninja Boy, and I will be back next time with more games of sorts. See you guys then.